Hey guys, so technically it is the 23rd, the 23rd of March, because it's 12:15. So I'm going to start this vlog as now and do a little intro for you. So as you all know, the schools have shut down here in the UK due to the coronavirus outbreak. I have just finished prepping and planning for Holly's first homeschooling day tomorrow or today, whichever way you want to look at it. I'm hoping it's not going to take this long every evening. Obviously, like, I've gotten on to Twinkle, which is something I've been recommended by the school and by other parents and things like that. I've gone on that to this evening, and there is a plethora of stuff for Holly to do for her particular key stage. She's key stage one. I have a very structured day. I'm taking this quite seriously. I think other parents are having a more lenient approach. I want to try and sort of like give Holly a nice little routine in the daytime. So I've got something for her starting from like 9 a.m. all the way through until 3 p.m. And even sort of like after that, if we do end up going out for a walk, not undecided whether that's like the right thing to do right now. You know, like social distancing and all that. So I'm talking gibberish because I'm a little bit tired. I'm hoping that this becomes a more easier routine to do. I've got a little like timetable as to what they would have been doing in school as such. So yeah, 9 a.m. tomorrow morning, we are be doing PE via the body coach, Joe Wicks. He has put out, and it's also on the Twinkle website, that he's doing like half an hour of fitness with children all over the UK, all over the world, if you want to tune in, at 9 a.m. GMT every morning with Joe Wick. So I'm really looking forward to that. I'm going to be joining in. I'm going to have my PE kit on as well. So yeah, come along for our homeschooling day-to-day daily vlogging. I'm not sure if I'll be getting vlogs up daily, because obviously I'm going to have to be like educating my daughter, planning what she's going to be learning the next day, all the while trying to like keep myself updated with the news and what's going on with this crazy pandemic that's going on in the world, trying to get Holly to like socialize via a sort of like FaceTime video sort of platform. Cook, clean, obviously like prep for her schooling the next day. I want to be able to like sit down and watch a film myself, and like have some time to myself as well. Otherwise, if I don't like look after myself, I'm not going to be able to like do anything. So yeah, homeschooling. Let's do this.
I want to be Lord of the Sky, Lord of the Stone Monkey. I'd make a much better job of it than you. Very well, said Lord
Buddha,
smiling. All you have to do is pass one simple test. You must stand on my wrist and jump over my fingers. Is that all? Laughed the stone monkey. I can do far. Go.
Try it.
Greater things than that. Lord.
Buddha.
Stretched out his hand and the monkey got ready to make his jumps.
Okay, so I haven't vlogged since the fitness this morning because I kind of like have been Instagramming instead, which is I'm just not used to daily vlogging, and I guess that's what has happened. So today I can show you what we have been up to. We did some maths. Can't remember what order we did these in. It's been a busy day. So we did some maths and there was a video for her to watch as well. So at the moment she's up to the point in maths where she can do her 2x tables, 5x tables and 10x tables. So it's just doing lots of homework with regards to that. So like, Natalie has 2 oranges and her mum gives her 2 more. How many oranges does Natalie now have? Tom has 3 cakes, Rabina has 2 cakes, and Hugo has 2 cakes. How many cakes do they have all together? So it's a case of like adding up in twos or taking away in twos. And then multiples of 5, again, same sort of principle. Hamza counted 5 toes on his left foot and 5 toes on his right foot. How many toes did he count altogether? Mr. White asks his class to count up in fives. They start at 20. What are the next 3 numbers that they count? 25, 30, 35. So, yeah, it's learning sort of like start midway, not always starting from 5. And then you sort of like colour by 2s multiplications. So each shape has a 2x table on it. And then the answer corresponds with what colour you've got to write it in. And then you end up with something like that. So it's like colour by numbers, but you've got to figure out what the answer is first. And then the same sort of principle, but for 5x tables. So 5x5 is 25. So 25 had to be coloured in pink. So she's coloured it in pink. Yada, 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 so on and so forth. We watched a few videos about learning about spring and stuff, didn't we? How the buds come out on the trees and the insects start coming out and buzzing, bees and lambs are born and chicks hatch out of eggs and little things like that. And then that took us up to 3 o'clock. Then we've been out for a walk with the dog, trying to socially distance ourselves. And then you just get idiots like walking close to you to say hello. And it's like, dude, come on. Like, it's people like them that are gonna force us to completely be in isolation. So yeah, how do you feel like you're, come here. Do you want to tell YouTube how your day's been? What's been your favorite bit about today?
Mindfulness.
So she's been asking for mindfulness all day. I think you really enjoy it, don't you? Don't know why, but yeah, there's something about you that likes to detach and just sort of like do some coloring and stuff, which is quite nice. It's a good way to calm down, isn't it? Not that you were all riled up, but it's a good way to sort of like switch off. And obviously you're still reinforcing all of those, you know, motor skills, fine motor skills, by colouring in, you know, super, super duper fine you know, like the relaxation colouring in drawings that you're supposed to do as an adult to like chill out. So obviously, you know, you get a bit more intricate like me, and then she's still, hang on, she's still block colouring like that, but like it's reinforcing colouring in the lines and being a bit more intricate and all those sorts of things, and then sort of like chilling them out. You know, they've learnt quite a lot. They're on a steep learning curve. I think that's what mindfulness is all about. Yeah, I hope you've enjoyed day one. It's sort of been just sort of a bit of a rundown of what we've been up to really, rather than anything else. But tomorrow I'm gonna make sure that I try and vlog properly. So yeah, I'll see you all tomorrow. Bye. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Jump, jump, jump. Jump!
You can't go all the way back.
Go again. Jump! Jump! Yes! Go again. Jump!
Again.
Jump! I would have filmed her reaction because she's just got out of the bath. That's why she's got a silly thing on her head. How excited are you? She was like, what's this mummy? And I was like, watch. And then the music came on for Sleeping Beauty and she was like, oh, Sleeping Beauty.
And I hugged you tight.
You hugged me. Right then, shall I go and play it?
Thank you.
just finishing off our English session for the afternoon. Holly's finished all the work that's been set from her teacher. And she's got a wobbly tooth. She's quite proud of it. Okay, that'll do.
Okay.
I don't think they can really see. So we finished off all the work that's been set by her teacher, and we finished off all the work that Twinkle have set for her particular key stage as well. And we've just been going over some, literally some basics, like letter formation. So just repeating, writing the letters of the alphabet, just to make sure that she's placing the letters correctly in the right place, right height and stuff on the lines. Just real basic stuff that she's done already, but absolutely no harm in going over stuff like that to make sure it's right down to how it's going to be needed. Where we are, Holly is entitled to free school meals up until the end of primary two. So hang on, wait, let me explain to everybody what's happening. So obviously because we are no longer able to go to school, she's still entitled to that service, which has been absolutely brilliant. So this is going to be given to us every Monday. Obviously it's Wednesday today. It's taken a little time for them to get things organised. So this is like our first instalment of a free school dinner, but for like the whole week, and they've called it like a free school hamper type of thing. So we're just going to literally show you what we get for a week's supply of what she would be given for lunches, as a sort of, you know, stay at home option. So the contents of the hamper apparently is going to vary, and they're only going to give you, you know, what you can get. So I think you're entitled to like a loaf of bread, either a kilo and a half of pasta or some baking potatoes, some tins of beans, a jar of jam, I think it is. And then for the fruits, you either get tins of fruit, fresh fruit, or a carton of orange juice. So it's just hit and miss what you get. So like I said, this should be coming to us every, stop it please, every Monday. But obviously the last couple of days have been absolutely crazy here in the UK, so it's taken them a couple of days to get organised. But they have just dropped it off to us this afternoon, haven't they?
Yo!
So first things first, like I said,
bread.
A whole loaf of bread, which is amazing. So it's a luxury, thick, white sliced bread from Braces.
And I love white bread.
You love white bread. Well, that's just as well then.
Yes.
What else is in here?
Like this. What is this?
This is pineapple. It's peach and pear. So these are, I guess, are what, like tinned fruit, which is, you know, if she doesn't like them, I think you'll like the peaches.
Yeah, I'll like the peaches. Not,
yeah, so those are good.
You can have the rest.
Because they just can stay in the cupboards. They will last up until February next year. So
oh my
Holly, gosh. Can you sit back? So they're quite good for emergencies. And then I think they've only given us enough for like the next 3 days. So for like today, I don't know. So there's like three bits of fruit. I would say that's 3 days like worth of fruit. So a massive tin of baked beans, 840 gram tin of baked beans, which is two tins of beans, really, that. So that's great.
And mummy, he's strong.
A tin of tuna, which isn't ideal because we're vegans, but you know, if a push comes to a shove, that can be great. Or I can text my neighbour and say, would you like a tin of tuna? I'll leave it on your doorstep type
of
thing.
Good thing I don't even like tuna.
And then we've got one, two.
Oh, make it mash.
Three, four.
Make it mash.
Five baked potatoes.
I want it mash.
So that's a you love mashed potatoes, don't you?
It's my favourite type of potato.
And potatoes are like a good store cupboard. So although they're considered to be like fresh fruit and vegetables, they do last longer than your average vegetable because they're quite starchy. So yeah, brilliant. So that's that for this week. No jam, which I'm slightly disappointed about. But in this sort of situation when you're being given things like this for free, then beggars can't be choosers. So don't you drop them on the floor.
I'm not going to drop them on the floor. They're my babies.
So yeah, that's that. What do you think of that, Holly?
Good.
Good. Yeah, me too.
of 12 is.
I'm sure they're supposed to be ladybird for you to colour in on those, but I don't think it printed out properly. So, yeah, right,
plus
carry on.
14. 7. Half of 16. Half of 18 is 9. Half of 20 is 10.
Good girl. Right, so on the orange one, half of 10 is? Half of 10 is?
Half five.
Of, yeah, so draw me 5 orange dots, please. 5 orange circles.
We are back at school and able to see each other again. Love, Chelsea. When we go.
Oh, to Holly, I will never forget you. Love from Chelsea.
Yeah, we always say that.
Do you always say that?
Yeah. See, I'm making a small.
Do you want to roll it out a bit thinner?
No.
No.
This off bits because we don't want this bit, we only want the inside so we can make something. How do you make it into a ball?
So scrunch it all back up together, like if you do scrunch on a piece of paper, scrunch it all back in like this, tight, squeeze, and then you start going like this. Yeah.
Oh, this is a unicorn head.
Right, are we going to put ribbons through these as if we're going to hang them up like decorations?
Oh, yeah.
Right, so
that
if
would
that's
be good.
That's the case. What are you doing, Hull?
We're planting seeds.
Yeah?
And now I'm going to put some soil over the seeds to keep them warm.
And what else does it stop birds from eating them and stuff?
Yeah. Because birds don't like soil.
But they do like seeds.
Yes.
There we are. Thank you. The first weekend of But I don't know, the first weekend of this weekly vlog, I guess this is going to turn into. Let me know in the comments down below if you want this in like a more of a shorter format, like every other day, every 3 days. I feel like I'm just going to bunch all of these clips together and take best bits from each day that we've been vlogging, along with some Instagram clips that I've happened to save or whatever. I'm actually going to use this product now. I've been using it quite liberally, purely just because my skin is drinking moisturizer at the moment, so I've been feeding it what it's been asking for, I guess. Only had one breakout so far, and that was, you know, I'm on my girly time of the month anyway, and I'd switched to a brand new moisturizer the night before, so I'm not sure which one it was, but it was like the tiniest spot and I haven't had anything since. So it could just be a little mixture of the both, plus obviously the amount of stress, I guess my body will be stressed in some sort of way, with the amount of stuff that's like changed recently. Everything's changed. So like, I'm not going to work anymore, obviously, because like my work establishment has had to close by government guidelines. And then Holly's not going to school anymore because the schools have closed by government guidelines. And then I've sort of like taken it upon myself to homeschool her. I've tried to find a little bit of like a balance. So I still wanted to have like some sort of structure to my day. Have, you know, like a dedicated lunchtime, a dedicated break time. Otherwise, I feel like you just end up sort of bimbling randomly through the day, not really achieving a great lot, and things get a little bit weird. So I kind of wanted to keep some sort of normality. And for normality for me, is routine. Me and Holly quite like routine. So like, even today on a Saturday, we've had a bit of a lie-in. But it's our normal, if she was with me on a Saturday, it's like when we would normally wake up. So like our routine has still been the same, but it's just been an hour later than what it would be on a normal weekday. So we've both naturally woken up at about 7:45, gotten out of bed at 8:00. And now we've just sort of like, instead of like making a mad dash to like have breakfast, I've let her have breakfast sitting on the sofa today because it's the weekend and stuff, which is what you would normally do on the weekend. Like, it's just more chilled out. So yeah, let me know in the comment box down below what you want. I felt like, you know, probably filming some of this is going to be good for myself and Holly in the future. And obviously to show our family what we've been up to, etc. It's a good little video diary type of exercise, I guess. But I've been doing a lot of like laundry and stuff like that, obviously, because I haven't been able to go to work, so I've got a lot more time to do it. And it's been amazingly sunny here. I mean, obviously not boiling hot. We've probably peaked at about 14 degrees, but that's great to get your washing on the line. So I've got like 3 loads of washing on the floor that I need to fold up and put away and stuff. But yeah, let me know how you guys are getting on. Like, what's going on where you live? I know there's a lot of you who watch me from different parts of the globe. What's happening in your country? Have they shut down the schools? I'm assuming that they have. yeah, let me know how you've been coping with the whole COVID-19 thing. I'm kind of trying to keep this like a positive place. Although like we're dealing, like what I'm showing you is a knock-on effect to something something negative that's happened. Who knows? I hope this is like a welcome distraction. Sorry I didn't get this up. Sorry I didn't have a video up for you on Friday last week. These are probably gonna be like a week late, so you'll see this week as it was. This is our last week. That makes any sense. So yeah, we'll see. Don't know, just gonna roll with it. And things might not be normally up on a Friday, that might be because we're busy, I don't know. Just bear with. I hope you can do that. That would be grand if you could. And yeah, speak to you all soon, I guess.
What are you eating, Hull?
We're eating s'mores.
And how did you make it?
Okay, so we got two biscuits, eight biscuits. Now they were in pairs of twos,
And what? Yeah. What did we put on one side?
We put on one side marshmallows.
Five marshmallows, yeah.
And then on the other side, we put five white chocolates.
Five white chocolates. Then what did we do?
Then we cook them in the oven.
Under the grill.
Yeah, we eat them.
And then we eat them. And what do you think? How many marks out of 10?
100.
100! Whoop whoop!